Flashback, the birth of mobile phones. They've revolutionized our lives. It's hard to imagine how we cope without them. Or young people.
A smaller brick phone hit the streets. It cost $4,000, and no one had an idea of the interruptions to come.
Mm-hmm.
Their size continued to shrink, and their popularity rose. Life before mobiles was very different.
There was expensive, having to hold plans. We had to make sure that if we were meeting someone, we had it really well organized.
Then in 2007,
it's a revolution. No. Now, who wants a stylus? We're going to use the best pointing device in the world. We're going to use a pointing device that we're all born with, the one with 10 of them, the fingers.
Back then, these features and concepts were completely new.
And so I can just move them towards the heart and stretch the inner.
They became a must-have item. These people have been lining the streets of New York for days. Not the theater tickets, free beer, or even money. It's to borrow this, Apple's new iPhone, the hottest gadget of the year. They replace cameras, video cameras, music players, clocks, calculators, radios, torches, street directories, and so much more. Experts tip future phones will make more use of augmented reality, blending the real and virtual world. But despite all these new devices, do we communicate better?
I think we communicate more, but I'm not sure.